Hello friends, most welcome to English Advantage online classes. Friends, in this video class I'm going to discuss 20 best spotting error questions for all SSC, banking and other government job exams. So this video class is going to be highly useful for all government job exams. Kindly watch it till the very end. You will definitely learn a lot of things. Now let us move on to the question number one. This is question number one, and question number one reads, the sun whose ray. Now here I want to ask one question. Does sun spread single ray or many rays? Definitely sun spread many rays. We always say rays of the sun, not ray of the sun. So here your answer is A. Here you have to say the sun whose rays. The sun whose rays. Okay. So here your answer is A. Question number one, your answer is A. Now let us move on to the question number two. Our soldiers were better trained than that of enemies. Now in this question, we are kind of comparing our soldiers with those of enemies. Or you can say our soldiers with the soldier of enemies. So since the noun of comparison is plural, you have to use those of, not that of. Okay, that of is used for singular, and this noun soldier is plural. So in place of that of, which is used for singular nouns for comparison, here you have to use those of, not that of. Okay, so here your answer will be C. Our soldier were better trained than those of enemies. Let us move on to the question number third. If it were possible to get near when one of the volcanic eruptions take place, we should see a grand sight. Definitely. Now after one of the noun is always plural. The noun is plural here, but after one of the verb is always singular because it is connected with one, that is singular. So here you have to say takes place, not take place. Okay, so here your answer is C. Let us see the next question. The aircraft was overloaded. There was something wrong of the battery. If there is something wrong, we always say something wrong with, not something wrong of. What is wrong with you? Okay, so here this preposition is inappropriate. So here your answer is B. Now let us move on to the question number five. A thorough inquiry of the misappropriation of funds. Misappropriation of funds means misuse of funds. Now this word inquiry is always followed by inquiry into, or you can say probe into. Okay. So this proposition is again wrong. Now these kind of questions are very trendy in current competitive exams. It looks very lengthy, but the kind of error is very subtle and very minor. Okay, so these kind of questions are very, very important for all banking exams, all SSC exams and other competitive exams as well. So here this word of is inappropriate. Now let us see the next question. While traveling by a train on a cold winter night, an argument rose between two passengers in our compartment. Now here you are using this fixed idiom in a wrong way. You always say, I went there by train, I went there by bus, I went there by air, I went there by road, not by a train. In place of by a train, you have to say just by train, not by a train. So here your answer is A. Let us see the next question. I cannot find where has he gone. Again in this sentence, a concept is tested. Since this part is not a question, that is why you have to write this whole part of the sentence in affirmative, not in the question, because if it was question, there would have been a question mark next to gone. So in place of where has he gone, you have to say where he has gone. Okay, you have to interchange these two words to make it grammatically correct, because this is not a question. and you cannot use question pattern here. So you have to say, where has he gone? Okay, so here your answer is B. Now let us see the next question. If I was the Prime Minister of India, I would work wonders, definitely. Okay, but this question is quite interesting. Now in this question, somebody is dreaming about becoming a Prime Minister, but this situation is not real. This is unreal. And to indicate the unreal situation, we always use were with all the pronouns. We always use were with all the pronouns in unreal situations. So you have to say, if I were the Prime Minister of India, I would work wonders. So here your answer is A. Despite the pills which are available, many people still have no sleeping. After this no, you have to use here noun. For example, I have no car. In the same way, you have to say, I have no sleep. I cannot sleep. I have no sleep in the night. So in place of sleeping, which is a continuous form, you have to say sleep only. That is the noun form. So here your answer is C. Let us see the next question. If you will buy one shirt at the regular price, we would have received another one at no extra cost. Now this question belongs to a condition. And this question is related with condition number third. That is unfulfilled condition. In unfulfilled condition, in the second part we use would have plus third form, and in the first part we use had plus third form. So in place of will buy, you have to say if you had bought. Here you have to use if you had bought. Okay, this is a very good question. So here your answer is A. Let us see the next question. Neither of the two candidates who had applied for the admission to chemical engineering department were eligible. Actually, neither and either are considered singular. So that is why in place of were, you have to use here was, because this is connected with neither, and neither and either are considered singular. So this word is wrong here. Here your application of pure grammar is tested. Okay, so here your answer is C. Let us see the next question, the beautiful surrounding of the hill. In English language, there are two words. One is surroundings and second one is surrounding. Surrounding is considered adjective. For example, surrounding blazes, and surroundings is considered noun. So here you have to use the noun form of surrounding because it is preceded by of. So you have to use here surroundings, not surrounding. So here your answer is A. Let us see the next question. The cause of the sudden explosion in the aircraft hadn't been discovered till today. In this question, the main keyword is today. You're talking about today. And today indicate present tense. So in the present tense, you cannot use past tense. So in place of hadn't been, you have to say haven't been. Okay, so B will be your answer in question number 13. Question number 14 reads, the ground outside the village abounding with snakes, the enemies of mankind. Here the main subject is ground. Okay, the main subject is ground. Ground is modified by this present participle. Ground is filled with snakes or abounding with snakes. Abounding is followed by either with or in. Okay, so you can say abounding with or you can say abounding in. And this is also a phrase that is modifying ground. Enemies of mankind. I think this sentence is correct and there is no error. Your answer will be D in this sentence. Let us move on to the question number 15. We had heard the engine roar as the plane began to move and we saw the people on the ground waving goodbye. Now in this sentence, the reader has used past perfect tense. But you cannot use past perfect tense in this particular sentence because when the plane begin to start, you hear the noise. Before the plane begin to start, you do not hear the noise. Okay, so you cannot use here past perfect tense. You have to use here only the simple past tense. We heard the engine roar as the plane began to move. That is how you have to correct the sentence. And here your answer is A. Let us move on to the question number 16th one. If it were not for you, I wouldn't be alive today. Somebody is thanking someone, okay? But here you normally say, if it were not you, if it were not you. This for is redundant here. This is needless here. So you have to say, if it were not you, I wouldn't be alive here. So B will be your correct answer here. Let us move on to the question number 17th. Widespread flooding is affecting, not affecting, because effect is the noun form, affect is the verb form. You have to use here verb form. So in place of affecting, you have to say affecting. Okay, this is quite simple. Often in political campaign, a point is reached at which the candidate take out their gloves and start slugging. Slugging means hitting hard with bare fist. Okay, this question has been asked in NDA examination, quite tough question. A point is reached. You always reach at a particular place, and place is indicated by where, not which. So in place of at which, you have to say where. Often in political campaign, a point is reached where. Okay, that is how you have to correct the sentence. And here your correct answer will be B. In place of at which, you have to say where. Let us move on to the question number 19th. He was bent upon to get selected. Now this bent upon is a phrasal verb, and upon is a preposition. Preposition is always followed by V-I-N-G form of the verb. So you have to say he was bent upon getting selected, not to get selected. So here your answer is B. This is also a very important sentence. Too great a variety of studies. This question has been asked in UPSC examination, a very important question. Since the subject is a variety, that is singular, you have to use the noun in singular. Destructs. You have to say destructs, not destruct. So C is your correct answer here. So that's it. I have used, I have explained 20 sentences in this video class. I hope you like it. And if you like this video class, kindly like it and share it with as many people as possible so that they can also be benefited with this video class. So that's it. Thank you very much for watching this video class. And I'll see you in my next video class. Thank you.